Hello everyone, welcome to the next episode of our show, Ode to the Past. In today's episode, we are going to talk about a book called Chocolate, or it was known as Chocolate in Hindi. It is a Hindi fiction book which talks about homosexual experiences, and it was written way back in 1927. Rup Vanitha, an Indian academic who writes on gender and sexuality, had translated the book into English for one of her papers. And in the introduction, she says, "Even if in a complicated way, chocolate gave voice to homosexuality in India at a time it was barely spoken of, linking it to the overall world of desires." The book, called Chocolate, was written by a writer called Ugra. Ugra, in Hindi, in English it actually means extremist, and he did kind of write things which were considered as extreme for that period of early 20th century and 19th century. He wrote about the homosexual experiences in the Indian urban city, and it led to one of the earlier public debates on homosexuality that came across in India. Ugra started writing this as one story in 1924, which was starting to be published in a Calcutta newspaper called Matwala. And after it started publishing in the newspaper, the editor received a lot of complaints and a lot of praises. And the thing was, people used to line up in front of the stores waiting for that newspaper to come, waiting to read that story, because that story was that famous during that time. And after coming under a lot of scandals, his friends asked him to stop it. However, he decided to publish a whole book for it called Chocolate. And I don't know if you have guessed it already, but the book was a huge hit. And there were lines again outside Calcutta bookstores where people were again waiting for that book, and it was sold out within 6 weeks. His characters in the book expressed the desire for beautiful male in a manner similar to conveying the desire for women, which was obviously normalized at that time. So desire for women was seen as normalized, but desire for men was something which was seen as scandalous at that time. And homosexuality was outlawed by the British in the 19th century as unnatural and immoral, as you can already see the infamous Section 377 of the IPC, which was, you know, given by the British only. And the taboo topic in public was being discussed in the form of pulp fiction. The stories did not really give affirmation to homosexual people of that time, though. In fact, the narrator expresses hostility and hatred to men having sex with men. However, the characters in the book are also given a space to express their emotions and experiences with other men. For example, in one of the stories, the school principal says to the narrator, "My people's goal in life is happiness. We will try to enjoy ourselves even in hell." So a parallel space was revealed where queer love was practiced in the city, in the colleges, in the hostels, cinemas, theatres, parks, jail, etc. So somehow throughout this book, we kind of get a distorted picture of homosexuality which was happening in early 20th century. And this book led to widespread discussion. There was a literal movement which was created against such erotic literature which focused on homosexual love. And that movement was called as the Gaslit Movement. And it means something which has inflammatory potential. And this Gaslit Movement was led by these very famous, very known writers at that period of time against such cheap, quote-unquote, cheap texts. A critic said, one of the critics says, "It is indecent and obscene because it is inflaming rather than extinguishing sexual desire." Munshi Premchand, another famous writer, he also wrote against the book, and he said that, "I consider the naked portrayal of bad desire in literature very harmful." He said there is no need to bring books such as Chocolate to literature. And according to the academician Ruth Vanitha, Ugra was attacked for two reasons. Number one, for his choice to break the silence around homosexuality, and for his deeply ambivalent depictions of homosexuality. So chocolate as a word also denotes male desire as deliciousness, as a delicacy. So Ugra kind of created these images of homosexual love as a happening thing in the urban life. And Ruth says, "Ugra's voice represents the homosexuality inclined man as an everyday man. Nagaraka, which is the city dweller who is the protagonist of the Kama Sutra, who is urbane, well-educated, attracted to beauty in either sex and familiar with Indian as well as Western literature, So the thing is, you kind of find this man to be everywhere, a part, an essential part of the urban life of the city. And maybe that was how, or maybe that was the reason why it created so much of a controversy, because perhaps sex was not that, you know, desire was not that hidden anymore. And even though it was banned, it was there. Okay, thank you. We have come to the end of this episode. Wait for our next episode. Till then, have a good time.